About 9 out of 10 adults experience back pain at some point in their lives. And 5 out of 10 working adults will have back pain every year. When back pain becomes unbearable and conservative treatments have been exhausted, spine surgery may be an option. We spoke with Dr. Joe Lee of Methodist Hospital in Arcadia to learn about advancements in spine surgery procedures.
So understanding the different parts of the spine and how it works will help us understand why we have pain and what we can do to help. So let's look at the different parts of the spine. Here are the bones. They form the column for the spine. They're called the vertebrae. And in between are the discs. They serve as shock absorbers for the spine. And right in the back, we have the joints called the facet joints. And they help to stabilize the back of the spine and also facilitate movement. Inside the canal runs the spinal cord as well as the nerves, and as you can see, the nerves sort of branch out at each particular level, going to each different part of the legs. So when the bones become weak or the discs start to wear out, you can get a lot more stress in the spine, and that transfers into the ligaments as well as the joints, and you can start to get arthritis. Also with wear and tear, these discs will start to flatten out, and just like a flat tire, when it flattens, there's quite a bit of bulging. And when that happens, it can close down on the space available for the nerves or start to pinch on them. And over time, all these factors sort of come together and can cause things like spinal stenosis, which is shrinking of the canal or the tunnels for the nerves. And that'll really pinch down on the nerves inside the canal as well as the nerves that come out here as well. Whenever there's severe pain, whenever there's instability in the spine, whenever there's real nerve damage going on, I'm more concerned, and I tend to do more surgery on those patients rather than stay with non-operative care. These patients respond very well to surgery because the problem is really the nerves or an instability, and surgery really addresses those issues. For lumbar spinal stenosis, there are a lot of treatment options. The main issue is the nerves are being compressed. So the main goal of the surgery is to decompress those nerves. When there's other things going on, which usually are, if there's disc disease or there's a lot of arthritis or instability or even deformity, then we start to think about fusing the spine as well. A lot of times we can treat the patient with just decompression, and decompression in itself can be done in several different ways. Minimally invasive surgery, or MIS, is a newer approach to spine surgery. It uses smaller incisions and techniques that avoid cutting the muscle or stripping it away from the bone. It's been shown to lead to less blood loss, less postoperative pain, and faster recoveries overall. A lot of the patients that I see that are candidates for minimally invasive spine surgery do incredibly well. I do fusions when there's one instability, or when there's deformity, or when there's bone-on-bone arthritis, and there's a lot of painful motion that occurs between the discs or between the joints. And just like any other joint, when it wears out, it can become quite painful. So fusion eliminates that movement and eliminates that painful movement. And of course, if there's deformity or instability, things are rocking back and forth, then fusing that segment will stabilize it and help relieve that pain. Generally speaking, surgeries for nerves, freeing up nerves, doing a microdiscectomy, those are very successful. Issues with the neck, very successful, and I'm saying more than 90% successful. Issues with just low back pain or disc pain, that can become a little bit less successful, and I tend to stay away from those surgeries and sort of do other modalities to help treat the patient.